that impairment is chilling. GOP Steve Schmidt terrified by Trump slurring Israel speech. Republican strategist Steve Schmidt said President Donald Trump shows clear signs of physical and mental decline, and he challenged GOP lawmakers to speak up. The president slurred his words during the announcement Wednesday that the United States would recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, and Schmidt said Trump's apparent impairment was even noticeable on the radio. Without the visuals of television, it's not the first instance. He's clearly slurring his words, Schmidt told MSNBC's Morning Joe. I don't know what the cause of it is. But when you combine it with Senator Bob Corker's critique that the President of the United States is unstable, that he's dangerous, when you look at the private comments that are made by members of Congress around his stability, you look at his actions in recent weeks. We look at the reality that on this day we talk about the Churchill-Roosevelt relationship, where the President of the United States is not welcoming the United Kingdom. Where there is a consensus among both parties in Great Britain that his presence next to the Queen is an assault on her dignity by him standing next to her. Schmidt continued, when you look at all of this, this is worthy of discussion. The question of his fitness, of his stability, is in the air, and it doesn't get better when you see clear impairments. I don't know, is that a tooth problem? Is that something else? Trump's personal physician, who Schmidt compared to a character in the slapstick Cannonball Run movies, claimed Trump was the healthiest individual ever elected, but otherwise no details are publicly available about his fitness. Presidents every year typically to Bethesda Naval Hospital for a checkup. Schmidt said, this president, to my knowledge, is departing that. We don't know what's going on, but this is a legitimate issue worthy of consideration. This is the man who commands America's nuclear arsenal. That video, that speech, that impairment is chilling. Host Joe Scarborough said numerous Republicans had told him, and co-host Mika Brzezinski, that Trump was not fit. Just as senior Democratic lawmakers had questioned Barack Obama's experience. We're hearing it time and time again, but at some point somebody has to go in front of a camera and say that. Scarborough said, if we're in the middle of a nuclear standoff, there are so many Republicans that have said that behind the scenes. I think for the good of this country, we need to have a public discussion, and Republicans other than Bob Corker need to start talking about it. MSNBC historian gobsmacked by Trump grifters, I've been shocked by my own naivety. SNBC's Joe Scarborough said Donald Trump never expected to win the election, but once he did, he and his associates immediately started cashing in. The Morning Joe host and historian John Newton were flabbergasted by reports that disgraced National Security Advisor Mike Flynn started using his position to conduct business deals 11 minutes into the inauguration speech. I've been shocked by my own naivety about this, about the grifter factor with this crowd, and the attempt to try and profit in real time from the presidency, said Newton, executive editor at Random House. A lot of us are accustomed to seeing, and perhaps questioning sometimes, how former presidents make money and build their post-presidential lives. Meacham continued, we've just cut out the middleman here, and this is example 7000 of how the Trump circle has basically tried to line their own pockets at a time when they're supposed to be managing and marshaling power on behalf of all of us. Scarborough said Trump and his campaign is a money-making venture, so it was not surprising the real estate developer and former reality TV star conducted his administration the same way. Donald Trump didn't expect to win, basically told us as much, Scarborough said. He won, but they were looking, it was all about money. They were making money. Building the Trump brand, making it huge, maybe start a TV network, what was going to happen after this, then they won. The remarkable thing is, it's still about making money. I think we are all a little naive. Nikki Haley drops a bombshell about Americans at the upcoming Winter Olympics. With tensions between North Korea and the United States threatening to boil over, UN Ambassador Nikki Haley says it is an open question whether American athletes will be sent to compete in the 2018 Winter Olympics that to take place February 9 to 25 in Pyeongchang, South Korea. "Those are conversations we're gonna have," she told Fox News' Martha McCallum. "We don't ever fear anything, we live our lives. We use our freedom, we have that, and certainly that's a perfect opportunity for American Olympic athletes to go and do something they've worked so hard for." After Haley's response, McCallum blocked back the question to get a clearer answer, asking, "So is that a done deal? Is the United States recommending that our team goes? Or is that still an open question?" "There is an open question," admitted Haley. "I have not heard anything about that. Though the Olympics would seem to be a major terror target. They have witnessed just 3 fatal terror attacks since 1970. The most infamous of them is the 1972 Black September massacre in Munich, in which members of the Palestinian Black September militant group captured Israeli Olympic athletes. All 11 hostage athletes were killed, as well as a West German police officer and 5 attackers, according to the Washington Post. Another terror attack took place on American soil during the 1996 Olympic Games in Atlanta. In that attack, a 40-pound pipe bomb loaded with screws and nails killed one person immediately, and a second person, a journalist, as they rushed to the scene of the attack. The most recent fatal attack of the Olympics took place during the 2008 Beijing Olympics, in which a man stabbed 2 Americans and a Chinese tour guide, killing 1. If the United States declines to participate, it would not be the first time. Americans led a 65-nation boycott of the 1980 Summer Olympic Games in Moscow to protest the Soviet Union's invasion of Afghanistan.